WILDR folks, Alicia here. Today we are going to be talking about how to know if you're in the right heart rate zone, even if you've forgotten your heart rate monitor at home. We'll give you a shortcut for each zone so you know what it feels like. And this is going to be important even if you haven't forgotten your heart rate monitor at home, but you're feeling like your heart rate monitor doesn't match what you thought the workout was supposed to feel like. Either way, you'll want to subscribe if you don't want to miss out on another video that combines the glory of sports science with the wonder of outdoor adventure. Today's information is going to be based on a five-zone system. So if you're using a five-zone system for your training, or if you're one of our clients and we're using a five-zone system with you, then this is the right video. Some coaches will use three-zone systems, some will use five, some will use seven. I've even seen a 13-zone setup. So make sure that if you're using these indicators, it is with a five-zone system. And if you have no idea what heart rate zones are, you're going to want to check out our video on that topic so this makes sense. Let's start at the bottom, shall we? Zone number one should feel incredibly easy. In fact, you should wonder if the workout is having any effect on your fitness at all. It's kind of has a nickname of the guilty zone or the super, super easy singing. Joyously singing Adele. You should be able to sing Adele while you're in this zone. That's how easy it should feel. Zone number two is in that healthy aerobic area. It should feel like you could run there for hours. At the end of your run, you should feel better than at the start, and you should be able to have like a heartfelt, deep conversation while you're running or biking in zone two. Zone two should feel like a 5 or a 6 out of 10. Zone three, if you want to get super specific, should be your 15K race pace. And if you don't have a 15K race pace, it should be kind of the natural black hole that you go to if you are running without a heart rate monitor. It's hard, but it's not too hard. I call it the black hole of training because we're not targeting any one physiological system specifically enough to make changes. But I'm getting too geeky. Zone three is your, I can run for a very, very long time. It feels hard, but not too hard type zone. Zone four is your race pace. If you're going out for like a 5 to 10K race, this is how that zone will feel. It's pretty hard actually, but it is gonna be in that like 8 out of 10 type area. Now, the fitter you are, the longer your heart can stay up in zone four without you having to stop or slow down. However, that's going to increase with training. So just remember thinking about that 8 out of 10 type situation. You can say a couple words, but you're trying to prioritize oxygen. This is in that anaerobic zone, and so that's why it's going to be pretty tough. Zone five is a whole nother beast. It is super hard. You are only going to be able to hold your zone five pace for 90 seconds to 2 minutes. It is really intense, kind of the almost as hard as you can type situation. This is the one where I like to say you feel like you're being chased by a bear, and it should definitely feel like a 9 out of 10. I hope that all made sense for you guys. Remember, if you forget the heart rate monitor at home, that doesn't mean you can't use zone training to make your runs more effective. Sometimes it's nice to throw that heart rate monitor aside as well and make sure you develop that connection with your body so you can check in and see how you're feeling anytime. Anyhow, that's all for today. Have a wilder day, folks.